Sports Information Director Adam Heinzen here, joined today by Wisconsin Lutheran College 10th year head softball coach Rachel Keel as her team preps to open their season next week in Claremont, Florida. Coach, thanks for joining me today.
Thanks, Adam.
Coach, as we take a brief look back at your 2010 season, the Warriors finished 11-25 overall and 6-18 in the Northern Athletics Conference. However, seven of your losses were just by two or fewer runs. Can you kind of talk about, maybe it wasn't one factor in those losses, talk about the keys to winning a close game?
Well, I know as I kind of reflect back on the season that there were several games that were close. And I think softball's a game that often is said to come down to inches or a second can make all the difference in the world. So it's actually something this group this year has been working very hard on. We've been cleaning up our mechanics of our throwing. We've really been working on our running form, trying to get that added edge. So when the game does come down to inches, hopefully this year we'll have the edge and we can overcome some of those close losses that we had last year.
Your team will throw out the first pitch of its 2011 season on Monday, March 14th in Claremont at the National Training Center Spring Games, opening the season up with 10 games. Talk about the trip to Florida. It'll be your third straight year at the National Training Center Spring Games, and 10 games, definitely a full slate to start the season.
We're excited to be leaving for Florida tomorrow, especially seeing as we still have snow on the ground here in Milwaukee. We're excited to be playing a different schedule. Our spring break got moved back a week this year, and so that pits us with 9 different teams. The only team that we have played in the past is Bethel University. Actually, I should correct that. 8 new teams. We're going to play Bethel University, and actually Carroll College from Waukesha. We'll be playing them down in Florida as well. So we're excited to see some different teams that we haven't faced. We're excited to go down and play. I think we're ready to play. 5-6 weeks indoors can wear a little bit on you mentally, so I think we're prepared. We're excited to be leaving in the morning, and we look forward to that first game on Monday.
And definitely nice to try to get a full slate of games in. Always tough in the Midwest to get your full schedule in, so that's always a positive. And then after spring break, you guys return home playing 4 straight doubleheaders, one a non-conference, and then roll right into conference play on March 30th, beginning the season with 8 straight home games at Warrior Field and 16 of 28 after spring break at home. Talk about how nice it is to return to home and play all those games on your home turf.
We're really excited. In fact, some of the returning players, we were talking in practice the other day how last year it seemed like we were always on the road. We were always taking the longer trips down to Illinois. And so we're all looking forward this year to being at home a little bit more. We're excited to have 2 additional non-conference doubleheaders when we come back as well. A new team that we haven't played in the past is Northland College. And so I think that will give us a great step into the conference play.
Coach, let's talk a little bit about your 2011 roster. A handful of newcomers, some veterans mixed in there as well. Beginning with the infielders, where do you see the infield shaping up this year?
We have a lot of shifts in the infield. In fact, other than one of our pitchers and one of our players that split time at first base, we'll have virtually a whole new infield. So we're excited to kind of shift everyone around defensively a little bit. So on the mound, we will have Kendra Thomas and Katie Tim and Jocelyn Bykowski. Then behind the plate, Morgan Dittmar will return and see most of the innings behind the plate with Emily Snyder, a freshman as well, filling in a few innings. Then going around, Lauren Mance will probably be at first base the majority of the time, with Jenny, our freshman, at second base, and Ginny Curtis at shortstop, and then at third base, Katie Sloan. Also seeing some infield playing time is going to be Daytona at third base, a sophomore, and Katie Tim also at second base.
That group as a whole right now, talk about how the infield has performed. I know, without getting outside, and like you said, you're kind of excited, obviously, to get outside and play on that diamond, but how does the infield look from the coach's standpoint?
I think it's good. I think we've made some changes that I think are for the best and will be an aggressive defense. I know that right now in many situations, they're looking to throw the ball. We're looking to pick runners off. They like to play an aggressive style defense, and that's something that we've been working to foster and working to create. So I look forward to seeing what they can do, and again, working on really being specific with our mechanics and trying to get the ball off. I also think that we'll have really good range with both Ginny and Jenny in the middle there. I think they give us a little bit added range in the middle infield.
And then talk about your outfielders. You lost two outfielders last year to graduation, but definitely some other experience coming back there.
This is probably the most depth that we've had in our outfield in the 10 years that I've been coaching. So we have some speed and we have some really great strength in our arms. In the center field, look for Mindy Shalinsky and Emily Snyder, again, two freshmen to come in and see a lot of innings. Both of them are left-handed. Both of them have excellent range, and so they will probably see innings in the center field. And left field, look for two more lefties in a little bit of time with Emily. And left field, also Courtney Meyer, who returns as a sophomore. And in right field, look for probably Jocelyn Mikowski, Kelsey a little bit, and then both of our main two pitchers, and Katie Tim and Kendra Thomas, also play in the outfield. And Kendra and Katie can go either left field or right field. So we have a lot more depth in the outfield. I think our accuracy is improved this year. Our arm strength is looking really well. So we're excited to really step up that aspect of our defense this year.
Let's go back to your infield. Talk a little bit about your players that will be in the circle. Katie Tim, definitely a freshman last year, made the all-freshman team through the first perfect game in school history. How excited are you to have her back in that spot?
I think Katie has been working very hard and really working to add to her arsenal of pitches. She's also been working on that accuracy as all pitchers are constantly doing. But I think she comes in really great shape and with the tenacity on the mound that she showed last year. So looking for another great season from her.
And then the newcomer, Kendra Thomas.
Kendra comes in with a lot of experience. She played high school at a very large public school in Michigan and against some really top-notch Division I level players. So she, even though as a freshman, has seen a lot of softball and seen a lot of high-level hitters. So we look for her to come in and to play like a veteran, really. We're excited because she also brings a lot of arsenal of pitches with her. And so I think the combination with her and Katie Tim is a really good combination and offsets. They have a lot of jump pitches, and their fastball accuracy is really high. And then rounding out that group will be Jocelyn Mikowski, and we'll look at her to fill in a couple innings here or there. Her main strength is in the outfield, but we look to her to fill in once in a while for us as well.
And then talk about the Northern Athletics Conference, obviously the fifth year of the conference now, and there's teams that have proven to be on the top, but talk about where you see the Warriors and where you'd like to see the team finish in the 13-team conference this season.
Well, I know as a team right now we haven't set a specific goal, but as a coaching staff we would really like to see our team be in that conference tournament at the end of the season. I think that we have the talent level to be able to achieve it, and I know that the girls right now, even though we're at the beginning of the season, have a tremendous chemistry amongst themselves that I think is going to really be important as the season goes. So our expectation is that we are competing to get in that tournament at the end of the season. We always look forward and get excited because the tournament is hosted at El Verno College, which is right down the road. So it means that our team has a chance to play. We don't have to deal with hotels or a lot of travel. We have a little bit of an advantage there. So we're really excited to be vying for that. I know, interestingly enough, that several teams are already on spring break. And it's kind of been interesting to see how they're doing. So as far as the preseason polls, I'm not sure things in the conference are really going to play out that way. I know last year there were a few teams that had a lot of upsets. Unfortunately, we were probably part of that, getting upset a few times. And so we just want to kind of go back into the conference and look to finish in that top six as we have consistently in the previous years.
Again, the Warriors open their 2011 season next Monday, March 14th in Claremont, Florida at the National Training Center Spring Games. The Warriors will play 10 games during the week before returning home March 26th, opening up another non-conference game against Northland College. Against 10th year head coach Rachel Keel, thanks for joining me today.
Thanks, Adam.